Okay, people, next up we have got another time switch. This one is made by Sangamo Controls. It's an ex-electric board bit of electrical equipment. And, well, let's get straight to the specifications on this one. I'm still on the second set of batteries, so they could go at any minute. So if it suddenly cuts short, then my batteries went. Right, specifications for this one. It's model Q-346. It's the switching capacity on this one is 100 amps, so it's got the same switching capacity as the Horstmann video that I done of the VA MK9. So it's got the same switcher capacity. It also does rate changer capability. So if you if it's needed for like a dual tariff application, that will activate the dual tariff also. It's a quartz movement, this one. There's no mechanics. Well, there's a bit of mechanics in there, but it's the actual motor driving it is quartz, as it says on the clock face. It says quartz on it. It's currently upside down. So it does do rate changer capability. For those of you who have seen my, it's the Sangamo Western S200.31 electricity meter video. You will notice, if I just pick my camera up a moment, you'll notice that this time switch has got that clear plastic case on it. That is because on my S200.31, which is an electricity meter, it has one of these cases on it. Because the cases are off these time switches. Let's just turn this around a minute. Ignore this, it's just a little thing to hold it up so I can film it. This is just the back view. Nothing too exciting around here. Again, you've got a carry handle, so you can pick it up and carry it. It normally stays down the back there when it's mounted to the wall. It's a wall mounting thing there. You can hook it onto the wall with a screw. There's also two screw fixing points down the bottom there. Let's turn it around a bit more. Again, nothing special to look at around the back, around the side. Nothing special to see. So there we go. The reason why a lot of electricity boards were discontinuing and removing these is because these have got a little backup battery contained inside them, and it gives 100 hours of reserve power, which is about 4 days. Now when you compare that to a Horstmann clock, which can run for 15 days around about approximately there, 4 days of reserve power really is a bit rubbish. So, you know, the problem with these is after about 10 years of service, the little backup battery actually gives out. Now, when it does give up, what happens is it creates a short circuit on the electronics, and it actually causes the clock to stop. It actually kills the clock off, it stops working. Of course, the way to get around that would be to remove it from service, have it apart, unsolder the battery out, put a new one in, put it all back together, and then put it back in service. I own two of these, and I've got another one currently in service. And what I've done is I've performed a nice little battery hack on it, and I've actually unsoldered the old battery and removed that, the actual proper little battery that goes inside those, and attached two big long leads off it, and then in parallel I've wired up two rechargeable AA batteries, and the AA batteries sit in the bottom there, inside that white case. They sit in the bottom there, and it works ever so well. You know, I'll cut the power off and the little clock just keeps on ticking away. I don't know how many hours reserve it would give in a power cut, but I would seem to think, because the batteries are much larger, and I think they're 500 mAh each, and there's two of them in there, so it gives me 1,000 mAh of battery storage power, and it runs ever so well. So yes, let's have a quick look at the terminals. We're 5 minutes and 15 in so far, and the batteries on the camera are currently holding up. The slide is down. Again, this is an X-electric board piece of stock. Right, what we have, that's the power in for the main contact, and the power out for the main contact. And I've got a feeling that there is the power for the synchro motor. Yes, that there's for the power for the synchro motor, as is that. That's probably live in the neutral. That there's earthing terminal. And that there is, I believe, the rate changer trigger. You put your wire in there, and it will activate the off-peak tariff on an appropriate electricity meter. And that one there, which I forgot to point out, that is just blanked off. There's nothing inside that one. That's really all I can say about that one. Again, if you look on, I don't know if I can get a focus in on it. There's a little label in there. It says 21, the line 88. Now the 21 refers to the 21st month in 1988. So I would seem to think that's somewhere in June. So that was manufactured in about June. I would seem to think, or May or June 1988 that was made. I don't know if I can get a zoom in on that. Oh, almost focused then. Oh dear. No, the zoom on this camera isn't really that good. It doesn't want to hold. It focuses and then goes out of focus again. So there we go. I don't know what that number 15 means. It's just a label that someone's stuck on there. But there we are. That's a rate changer clock made by Sangamo Controls. Quartz movement. It's not a synchro motor. It's actually quartz movement inside that one. Again, it's got the on and off togs in there. On this particular one, it's actually only got one on and one off. My other one that I own does actually have two on and two off. So there we go. And I've got a feeling the other one's a Q-346 as well, because they've done two of these. There's a Q-345 and a Q-346. This one also does not have the day emission device in it. That there, there's a little device that goes inside there, and you can actually omit a day operations, or should I say the electricity board. Again, on the top here you've got an anti-tamper seal. There's another one down the bottom there, and also one on the terminal cover, because these, really speaking, they were installed by electricity board and were not available for the end user to set and operate. They were put an anti-tamper seal on there, and then that was it, you know. And they would operate storage heaters and the immersion heater and things like that on an off-peak tariff, because when these turned on and activated all your storage heaters and whatnot, it also triggered the off-peak tariff on the electricity meter. So there we go, people. That's a nice little time switch there. This one has yet to be restored by me. It's actually dead at the minute because of the previously mentioned battery problem that it has. If I tried wiring it up now and running it, it would actually just not start up. You get no response from it at all. So I'm going to have to either replace the little backup battery in there or perform a little battery hack on it and do my AA battery stunt with it. So there we are. Coming up next, just so that you know, we've got this nice little treat. Another one made by Sangamo Western. Electricity meter. So come back for that. That's coming up next. The batteries are holding out, so hopefully I should be able to get that other electricity meter in also. Okay then, people, thanks for watching.